Medical bias by race and gender is a well-documented problem in American healthcare. The important question today is what we can do about it. We adopted a radical new approach to reducing medical bias using network science. We placed hundreds of clinicians into engineered information sharing networks to see whether this approach could alter how clinicians perceive patient information, leading to reduced bias in their treatment recommendations. We recruited 840 clinicians to participate in an experiment. They were asked to watch a video of a patient giving a clinical history, which included risk factors for coronary artery disease and an electrocardiogram chart showing abnormalities. For half of the clinicians, the video featured a white male actor portraying the patient. For the other half, the video featured a black female actor. Apart from the race and gender of the actor, the videos were identical. After watching the video, clinicians chose from four possible treatment options: unsafe treatment, undertreatment, the correct guideline recommended treatment, or overtreatment. We found that the black female patient was far more likely to receive the unsafe treatment, while the white male patient was much more likely to receive the correct guideline recommended treatment. Then we grouped the clinicians into two conditions, experimental groups and control groups. The experimental groups were put into engineered peer networks with 40 members, in which each clinician was connected to four other clinicians. After each round of assessment and recommendation, clinicians saw the responses of the four peers they were connected to in the network, and then they rewatched the video and provided their responses again. The control groups watched the video by themselves with no input from other clinicians. The results from the control group showed no change in medical bias. The black female patients still received recommendations for unsafe treatment far more than the white male patient, but the results from the experimental groups were remarkable. After interacting in engineered information sharing networks, race and gender bias was eliminated. Clinicians gave the correct guideline recommended treatment to both the white male and black female patients at the same rate. Strikingly, we also found that putting clinicians into structured information sharing networks improved healthcare outcomes for both the black female and white male patients. These findings show the promise of using network science in hospital systems to provide safer healthcare for women and minorities. Particularly in the emerging fields of telemedicine and online clinical support networks, there are clear opportunities for structured information sharing networks to reduce bias and improve quality of care for everyone.